Okay, guys, how are you doing? Okay, the course which has been used for all the subjects, all the programs. Okay, that is called the interdisciplinary courses. So, you know, control system is interdisciplinary course, and we have to focus on that, and it is actually based on the mathematical course. This one mathematical course. That means I'll show you some mathematical problems, some designs, and based on this we'll conclude the whole syllabus. Okay. But at the first chapter, you would get some theoretical concepts, but later you would not get that much theory. From the later chapters, we'll get the mathematical terms most of the time. Okay. So first of all, now tell me, what is your status so far? The other courses and the due status. What is the status of yours, Rizvi? Rizvi, have you completed all the courses in the last semester?
Yes, sir.
Or Ismail,
can you what?
Have you completed all the exams or the assessments in the last semester?
Yeah, complete everything.
Everything.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll take your viva. Okay, I have not taken it yet because I'm waiting. Few of your friends have missed the assessment. Okay, I'll take in the meantime.
No problem, sir.
And what about others? Abdiaziz, you complete all?
Yeah, we complete, yeah.
Okay. What about Mithun?
I only left in, it's on, only me, your FIFA left me.
FIFA left, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll take it later.
Okay. Yeah, fundamental communication, yeah,
Ramadan, and in the Ramadan we have the reduced class because we are fasting. I do not know what about you, but I am fasting. I think you are
fasting too.
You are fasting, okay.
Yeah.
So that is why the authority reduced the class time as usual, you know. And the pandemic situation is ongoing. And last 2 days, 101 people died officially.
Yeah,
in coronavirus. So that is alarming situation. People infected every day. The infection rate increases. So that is the problem. And if we open the university, then the student will come and the rate will also increase. You'll be in trouble. So that's why government is restricted this thing, education institute. Okay, so whatever, we have to maintain this thing as well. So let's look at the control systems, what it is. Let me share you whiteboard. Okay. So, photo system, our course name is control system. Yeah. So how would we proceed? You know, we have first test. Class test or quiz, actually. And we have presentation. Meet final. So meet, you know, meet 20, final 15. And these are presentation class test, 10, 10. And attendance 10, okay. 50, 70, 20. Okay. So here, these are the usual thing. Okay, at least one or two, I'll take two. Best one would be count one presentation. Okay. So if I take, if you want, you can skip the, okay, we'll decide it later based on the situation because we do not know what would come. Maybe lockdown will enhance. There is a possibility. Okay, that is the thing called system, the mark distribution systems. Okay, in the mid, you know, 10 mark assessment, 10 mark viva, simple. And here, say 30 mark assessment, 20 mark viva. That's it. Okay, so you see, viva is the important factor here. Whatever it is, if I take the 50 marks assessment, I would count it on the 30. And if I take the 20 marks meet, I count it at the 10, within the 10. Okay, so that is the thing, that the viva is important. See 30 marks on the viva. So you have to try to understand what I am throwing to you. Okay, otherwise you would not understand that the course contents. Okay, so book, textbook, we have mainly one book, textbook. I have one textbook, which is the Simon Ramo. The name is actually Control System, I guess. Systems. Simon Ramo. We have that is the main book, Simon Ramo. Okay. Control system. I'll give you the soft copy. And we have another book, that is the Modern Control System. Modern Control Systems. That is written by Bishop and Dorf. Bishop and Dorf. Whatever. So if you look at the dots, then you'll find this one. So I'll also give this one too. But our main book is this. Simon Remo. Simon, that is our fundamental book, textbook. But I'll take few things from the modern control systems, which has been written by Bishop or Dorf. Okay. So today, I'll just show you the books. But I would not show you any theoretical things. Just I will give you some idea. From the next class, inshallah, Thursday, from the Thursday, we will start the theory, main contents. Okay, today I will not discuss about the main contents. Just today I will discuss about the things. And today I think I will give you the classroom link. You join there from the beginning, and I will upload the video, inshallah, and other contents. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. In the last semester, I have lots of day shift courses, but this semester I have only one course in the day shift, so it is easier for me. Okay, take the all things. So you can share it. But in the last semester, I was puzzled. Many courses on that issue. I think 4 courses. Okay. Okay, so that is the thing. So let's look at the books. Now we'll see the books. Let's move on the books.
Okay. So, sir, in general, and what kind of lectures this course focus?
Lectures, I'll give you the PowerPoint. All chapters PowerPoint. I'm explaining everything right now. Okay, see, that is our book, Norman S. Nice, main book, Control System Engineering. Okay, so I have the 6th edition soft copy. So I'll give you this one. Okay, see. What is this? It is a robot, right?
Yes.
Robot. So it is not possible actually to make the robot by reading this course, by completing this course, but you would understand the basic things. How to develop the concept. Okay. So fundamental base of this control system. Okay, a robot is a mechanical thing, and also the electrical part also there. See, these things, this arm, you have to build this arm. This is a mechanical thing. But to run this robot, you need the electrical concept or the electronic concept, right? To run this one. Okay, but for the building the robot, for the making the robot, you need the mechanical concept. So in the control system, we have to look both mechanical as well as the electrical concept. Okay, combining the both, we can make the robot. Let's see, what would be the contents and how many chapters we'll look. So that is our main book, Norman S. Nice. Who is he? He is a professor of California State Polytechnic University, Pomona. Okay, USA. He's from the USA, United States of America. Okay, so his book, we'll take a look. Okay, so what we'll see? What is my plan? And this book published by John Wiley & Sons Incorporation, and first edition when? See. First edition, 1996. Then 2003, 2006, 2011. This book is 2011. Okay. Now see the contents here. So first of all, first chapter, we look at the first chapter. I have I have a PowerPoint slides of the first chapter, so I'll give you that. Don't worry about the things. That is the first chapter introduction. So in the introduction chapter, we'd see the definition of control system and history. I'll say some history, but it is not obviously to know. Just you glimpse of history, introduction, as well as the analysis and design objectives, how to design a control system, control system types, control system definition. Okay, all things will come there, and we'll see some examples of the control system. You know, the hard disk. The hard disk of the computer, not the SSD drive, not the solid state drive, just the hard disk. That hard disk, HDD, hard disk drive. This hard disk also is the example of the control system. And if you look at the lift, elevator, these are also the example of control system. Okay. So these things, we'll see that. And the rocket. See the NASA. Launch the rocket through the rocket to the space. This rocket system is also control system, and the autopilot system, the aircraft, that is also control system example. Okay, so lots of control systems are there, and the radar system also example of control system. Okay, so we'll see these things, everything we'll see these, all of these here. Okay. In the introduction chapter. Now, chapter two is the modeling in the frequency domain. We can model a system in two domains. One is frequency domain, another one is time domain. Okay. So time domain is comparatively new, but frequency domain is the old one. So here in the frequency domain, chapter two is a large chapter. You have to see many things. So we will review the Laplace transformation here. Laplace, I think you have studied the Laplace in the signal system and the DSP, right?
Yes.
Laplace transform, at least idea. So those idea will be required here. Okay, those idea will be required here. So see, the Laplace transform concept is required to do the problems based on the control systems. Okay, so see here, we'll see what we'll see the electrical network and the mechanical system, rotational mechanical. See, electrical network transfer functions, translational mechanical system transfer functions, rotational mechanical system transfer functions for systems with gears. Electromechanical system transfer functions, electric circuit analogs. No, we will not see this. Up to this 2.8. Okay, up to 2.8. We'll see from 2.1 to up to 2.8. Not all the things. Okay, so basic things actually. These are the basics. So we need to know up to 2.8. We'll see here from the chapter two. Okay, so I have a plan that. Maybe one or two classes is required for the chapter one. And I'll take some time for the chapter two. Okay. For the chapter two, maybe two plus. And see the chapter three, modeling the time domain. See, this is modeling the frequency domain. That is modeling the time domain. So we'll see the modeling the time domain. This is the model. So in the time domain analysis is the concept of the modern control system, the fundamental of the modern control system. But if you have the another course based on the control system, in that course we'll show you the modern control systems. But that is for the master's level course. That is not the undergraduate level course. In the undergraduate, we do not complete the modern control system because we do not have that much time. Okay, so that is another simple chapter. Here we'll see the what is the time domain analysis, and we'll see the general state space representation, and we'll see how to apply this, and converting a transfer function to state space and the state space to transfer function. That is up to 3.6. So here from 3.12 up to 3.6, I will say this. Okay. That is the chapter 3. And see here, some case studies are there. So if possible, if you complete the all the problems given at the end of the chapter, then absolutely you will get the idea how to develop a robot. I'm damn sure. But we have the limitations. We have the time limitation. That is why we cannot give you these problems. But I'll try to give you some case studies. Okay, so that you do your study at your home and your analysis. Then you will develop some ideas. Okay, okay, another one, the time response. Okay, the thing is, actually I do not take the signal system as well as I do not take the DSP courses. Okay, these are not my favorite one. But for the sake of the university, for the sake of the department, I have to take those courses. But this control system is my own course because I am taking this course since many years. Okay, so that's why I have some good idea about this. Okay, I can say everything here. Okay. So see, like the fundamental of communication. Okay, that course, this course, and the microwave engineering, mobile communication, those courses are my regular course. Okay, but the DSP or signal system, those are I would say the stopgap course. That means your teacher is gone, so I have to take this one. Okay, whatever. So time response, that is another one, another interesting chapter. In this chapter, we'll see from the 4.12, okay, up to 4.7 or 4.9, I think, up to 4.9. Okay, we'll look at the 4.9. This is the simple chapter because it is not the hard one. Short chapter, this chapter 4. Okay, and see. I have a plan to complete up to chapter 4 for the midterm. Okay, for the midterm, we'll try to complete up to chapter 4 for the midterm. Chapter 4, that is my target. I do not know, is it possible or not to complete the chapter 4, up to chapter 4 for the midterm exam or midterm assessment. And see, then we'll look at the chapter 5. Here we'll reduce the multiple subsystems. That means we have multiple systems, we have to reduce these systems into one. Multiple blocks, if you have the multiple blocks, let's say if you have two systems, if you have three systems, then you need to merge those systems and make one. That is the reduction of multiple subsystems. Here, we'll see up to 5.1 to 5.7. Reduction of multiple subsystems. Okay, copy this. Then we'll move on to stability, another chapter, important chapter. From the stability up to 6.5. Okay, I'll show you all, inshallah. Then we'll look at the steady state errors. Steady state errors up to 7.7 or 7.8. Whole chapter is important. These are the small chapters, but those are important. Okay, then we'll move on to root locus techniques. That is another technique, root locus. Root locus, okay, up to 8.10, all things are important. Actually, I'll give you some definitions and I'll show you some example. That is from the each one, from the each topic, I'll give you definitions and some example. Like this, you will complete the chapters. Mathematical example. Definition, let's say, what is the, how to sketch the root locus, then I will show the example of root locus. By solving one or two examples, you will understand all. Okay, that is the technique. And design by a root locus. That is another chapter. If I get time, then I'll show you some things from the 9 and 10. Frequency response techniques. Okay. From the chapter 9 and from the chapter 10, we'll see few things. And see, chapter 10 is important that we have to use the semilograph, log paper. Okay, log paper to complete this one. Let me show you one thing. This is a semi-log paper. See, these are the semi-log paper. These paper are known as the semi-log paper. So you need the semi-log paper. These are the not semi-log paper. I'll give you the soft copy of the PDF of the similar paper. Okay, then you can solve this one. This is actually thought, okay. Decade, everyone is a decade. Let me rotate it. Rotate right or left. See this. These are actually decades, each decade. 10. Okay. This is known as the logarithm graph. This kind of graph is known as a logarithm graph. We would regard this one. This is one decade. We can use this one, this kind of graph. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 decade. So 5 decade. 10 up to 10. Okay, we'll explain this one in the chapter 10. to chapter 10. Okay, in the chapter 10. So in the chapter 11, we have the design via frequency response. And chapter 12 and 13, those are the actually modern control system. So if I get the time, then I will show you the chapter 12 and 13. But in general, I would not show you chapter 12 and 13. So roughly, we have a plan to complete up to chapter 11. Okay, up to chapter 11. And in the lab, you'll see chapter 8, chapter 10, chapter 11. Those chapters will become in the lab. Okay, in the laboratory. So for the lab, oh, see here, they have given some MATLAB tutorial also here. Some MATLAB tutorials are given. See. And MATLAB. Yeah, MATLAB. This course based on the MATLAB. So if you have the MATLAB, then I can take the lab. You have to make sure that all of you have the MATLAB on your laptop or the computer. Okay. Then I can move on. Otherwise, I cannot do anything. Okay, that is the problem here. Okay. So that is the chapter, this book, from this book. So I'll give you the frequency, I'll give you the PowerPoint slide from each chapter. My own PowerPoint slide, which I have been made. Okay, I'll give you one by one. Not all at a time, but one by one. Inshallah. Okay. So do not worry about the contents, but you have to take a look at the books, because in the book, they explain everything. I just take the main things from the books. Okay. Let's say one definition, one example, but to understand all, you need to take a look at the books. Okay. Because relevant topics for the relevant examples, you have to take a look on the book. That is the thing. That's why book is necessary. So our target is go to the chapter 11. Okay. So if I get time, then I'll show you also the 12 and 13. Okay. So our main objective is to complete the book as much as possible. Okay. That is our main book. And see here, some parameters given. See, this is a block diagram. This is a closed loop control system. This kind of block diagram is known as the closed loop control system. And here, see, it is the radar system. The radar system, how does it work? And the block diagram of the radar is this one. It is a block diagram of the radar. Okay. That is the block diagram of the radar. This system layout. It is known as the antenna azimuth position control system. This one have the schematic diagram, this and the block diagram of this, and some parameters are there. We'll see this one. Okay. That is the example of a control system. So if possible, I would suggest you to buy this book. If not possible, we can have the soft copy. Okay. And that is another book, Modern Control Engineering from the Ogata. Katsuhiko Ogata. We have this one. I think he is from the Japan. That is another book. I would not prefer to look at it, but I would prefer the Dorf book. Let me show you the book of Dorf. I do not know where it is. I can't find that book. Book of Dorf. Okay, I would give you this that book because right now I do not know where it is. The book of Dot. Whenever I get the book, I'll give you. Okay. The book of Dorf, because that book is necessary. Okay, I'll show you that book later whenever I get. Okay. So Dorf is the this book I will take few things, but you no need to look at this book. Okay, same thing from that book also: transfer function, impulse response, okay, modeling in the state space. All things are same, but we will focus on the one book. Not the other books. We'll focus on the one book. We'll study that book, then we can understand more. Okay. Say control system design state space. Control system analysis state space. PID controller. Oh, PID controller. From this book, I'll show you the PID controller, I think. PID controller. So PID controller concept I will show you from this book, and other things are same. All books are same actually. Rearrangements are different. Okay. So that's it for today. From the next class, I will start the theoretical part. Inshallah. And how many students are there today? I need to take the attendance.
Almost 7.
Okay, just a minute. Let me write. Today is the 18th of April, right?
18.
Hi, bolo. we are waiting for the decision of UGC, what they are saying. Okay, and how we would give you the results, everything. So authority will decide all of the things. Okay. So we are waiting for that. So whenever I'd be free, I take your assessment and Viva. Okay.
Okay, sir.
After meeting, and if they do not impose any other words, then I can take the Viva or assessment. Okay. It depends on my schedule. Okay, so the class one, that is our class one. Roll number one is there, Sanjida. Three is there, Munir.
Roll
two is there. And 8, 14.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Yes.
Sham. Ismail,
yes,
Sham.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Roll what?
Roll 10.
Roll 10.
Yeah, 14.
Yeah. I know you. Mithun 6. So how many students are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 students are there. Some of missing, right? What is the total number?
12.
Munir, koto? I do not hear Munir because he has some internet problem. So can you, other students can tell? Yeah, here? Yeah?
Yes, sir.
12.
12, 6 Somalian and 6 Bengali.
Okay, so from the 12 students, today we have got the 7 students only. Okay, so try to tell others, your other friends. And okay. I think, do you need another messenger group or same group is enough?
If same group is enough.
No, okay. Just rename the group title. Okay, control systems.
Sir, it's not so much if this group would be.
Okay, it's okay. And I'll give you the Google Classroom link, new one for the new course. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So I'm closing this one. Okay, let me check the roll number again. Just see. Roll number 1. 2, 3, 6, 8, 10, and 14.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so I'm closing this class.
Yeah. Allah Hafiz, sir. Okay.